why do we question the idea that only that which has form is real? Because when we examine what form is, any form, this hand, this eyeglass, this nose, this shirt, when we examine any form, we realize that the experience of that form is the fluctuation of vrittis. Vrittis are fluctuations of consciousness that we experience in a limited way through this biological apparatus as sense perceptions, inner bodily sensations, sensation of breath, as sense perceptions like sound, touch, sight, taste, smell, but also as feelings, you know, feelings and emotions and thoughts and imagination. All these are fluctuations of consciousness, of vrittis. So every form that you experience, doesn't matter what that is, that book or that painting or this body or these glasses or this shirt, these forms are actually phenomena. And as phenomena, they're the fluctuations of that which is formless. So the formless, of course, is timeless. It has no boundaries. It's infinite. And the form that it assumes as a result of its own fluctuations is its own experience as form and phenomena. Shiva and Shakti, back to what spiritual traditions have said before. So Shiva is the formless, boundaryless, and Shakti is all phenomenon which appears as form. But the form is actually, in a way, an illusion because it is time-bound and it is the result of the fluctuations of the phenomenon that is the behavior of the formless. And so the invisible and the visible go together, except that the visible is time-bound and the invisible is timeless. So who should you and I have an allegiance to? What is the I am in the midst of I am this or I am that? And it becomes kind of obvious that the only allegiance we can have is to I am, which is beyond I am this or I am that. And therefore, we need to reframe the concepts of birth and death. Birth, what we call birth, is the appearance of boundaries. And what we call death is the dissolution of boundaries. And they go together, birth and death. And then what is life then? Life is both. Life is the continuum of experience as form and phenomenon, but also the subsiding of that form and phenomena into the formless that gave rise to the form and phenomena. So life is the continuum of birth and death. It's the eternal dance between the invisible and the visible. Eternal dance. And we can't have one without the other, except that the invisible is eternal and without cause, and the visible continuously recycles as the universe, as this body, this mind. But not only does it recycle, it evolves into complexity. That's the best word I can use. And the more it evolves, the more complexity that appears is the expression of the digital workshop in timeless being. Once we totally comprehend this, not just intellectually, but experientially, then we are liberated from the concepts of birth and death. Liberated from the concepts of birth and death. And we find freedom to also know that it is I am that is constantly recycling as everything that we call the universe, everything that we call the universe, from the larger than the largest to smaller than the smallest. And this is where David Bohm's idea that we are holo movements in a holographic universe is a very good idea, because it's also liberating. You never really die. You just rest in the formless and then resurrect as form and phenomenon. But that form and phenomenon is reminiscent of something that has happened before, but also new in that it is ever evolving through complexity into forms and phenomena. And we are that, the invisible I am, without which there is no visible I am this or I am that. Okay, I was thinking this morning when I woke up that we used to teach a course at the Chopra Center called The Seduction of Spirit, and part of that course was going deep into the Yoga Sutras of Patanjali, especially the vibhutis, the so-called supernormal powers or supernormal capacities or dormant non-local potentials. Now that we don't have that course anymore, I'm thinking maybe to create a new course online which would include the Yoga Sutras of Patanjali, but also incorporate the teachings of the Vedanta, Bhagavad Gita, Shaivism, Tantra, all incorporate that into a very specific course. Which we could call mastering quantum reality and the awakening of supernormal dormant capacities. If you think that's a good idea, I will start working on it. Let me know. It'll be a bit of work, but it could be very enjoyable. Okay.